What's up, YouTube? This is a 2001 BMW 325i E46, and today I'm gonna be changing the valve cover gasket. First thing you're gonna do is gonna need to get these little things here. This is the cab filter, or the cabin filter, whatever you want to call it. Cab's mostly for trim. Mine's a bit dirty. You're just going to lean that up somewhere. It won't get messed up or scratched. You're going to pull this off, lean it up against it too. Now, I have never done this before, so if you're wondering if I've ever done this, I've never have, so this will be the first time. Anyway, these should just slide right off, if I'm not mistaken. May have to persuade them, but they're usually easier. They may not be on BMWs, I don't know. I ain't really putting any effort into it, so yeah, you have to put effort into it. Yeah. Just pull it back a little bit. You're gonna have to work around that, because there's no really, no moving it. And gonna need a T25 bit. There's four bolts right there. I'm gonna go get that now. All right, I got my bit, but this is just, you know, this is a standard bit set. You can find it anywhere. You can get it on Snap-on trucks, stuff like that. This actually came with a drill set of mine, so had it for a long time. You can use different bits. You ain't got to use the same thing. Exactly what I use. They're actually for a drill, a Snap-on quarter-inch drill. But I don't want to get my drill out, so I'm just gonna do it with a basic gear wrench bit driver. So mine's a little wore out, as you can see. So I have to use a bigger, no, I got it. Mine's a little wore out, so I gotta be careful not to break it or break the teeth on it per se, because I used mine a lot, so especially with that drill. So you could tell it's kind of wore out. No big deal, but it still works. These things are pretty tight in there. Alrighty. Could have used an impact, but this is just a quick job. It's no, I ain't worried about it right now. My impacts are dead, so I don't really want to get them out. Come on. This valve cover gasket has been changed before, though. I knew the previous owner of this car, and he said he had changed it. Cause I asked him, because when it started leaking, I asked him if it had ever been changed. He said he had did it. He was trying to explain to me how to do it. He's like, man, I watched this guy on YouTube, and it took him 15 minutes, took me 2 hours. I was like, golly. I don't know how long it's gonna take me. I don't think it'll take me that long. I don't think it will. I always just put my bits up there. I ain't really particular where I put them. Or not my bits, my bolts. It's Just put this there. This thing comes out. Now you can see the whole valve cover. Now what's next is you want to take a flathead. Just any kind of small flathead. Mine's already missing right here on one side. Let you just pop these out. No big deal. They come out pretty easy. Some of them actually shoot when you pop them out sometimes. Mine are wore out, so that one wasn't. That one would have shot if I hadn't grabbed a hold of it. And these are 10 millimeters. These are two nuts, and these are two bolts. So you just grab a 10 millimeter. This is just the injector cover, but you will have to take it off to get the valve cover off. So that is all the injectors. Gotta take the cap off. Pick this up. Slide it out. Now there's all the cool packs. And you stick the lid back on so you don't drop anything in there or, you know, get dirt in it or something like that. This is an older style clips. I didn't know they had these on there. Although I'm sure I just raise up like that and you just pull the wire off. It's no big deal. It's pretty simple. Gotta remember that. This. Gotta undo that. A lot of people forget that. And they pick the valve cover up, bust it right then. So, and it's the oxygen sensor, so something you gotta have. So you need to be careful when you're pulling that off. Always remember to take those off. And the cords stay in there, so you're gonna have to, you know, track them down, get them out. Always pull them up, get them out of the way. Clip was broke. All right, you gotta pull your cool packs out, and these are all 10 millimeter bolts. There's two in the back, and then they're through there too. They're not too bad to get to, like this one back here. May cause a little trouble, but it's not really that big a deal at all, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, I'm gonna, and then there's little 8 millimeters in here that you, there's four of them you got to take out. I believe it's just four. Three, four. Yeah, just four 8 millimeters. They're just grounds. Take those out and you'll be golden. All right, now you would, now you're gonna start taking the eights out like I was talking about. Like I've already got this one off and I took that wire off. That's where you're gonna start that. And then this stud's just gonna come completely out because it's too tight. But it's no big deal. All right, let's get started. Start on the 10 millimeter bolts, which is these on the outsides, and then in the middle, which that one's already gone, that one, and that one. So it'll be four in the middle, and then however many around the sides. I don't think I'm gonna sit here and count, so just bear with me, I guess. All right. Broke down, went and got my drill. It's a quarter inch drill. It's a little attachment here. That's all it is. Works fantastic. I was gonna do like the whole tutorial with, like, you know, just a ratchet and just little everyday things you can get like at the dollar store basically. But this is taking very long, so I'm just gonna do it this way and just see how much faster that is. Loose and it's coming up. Should be able to pick it up no problem and slide it out like so. The whole gasket I can see is already coming off. Golly. Just for future reference, everyone, gaskets and silicone do not go together. They do not. I know from experience, so take it from me. They do not go together. They will leak. So either you put silicone on it or you put a gasket on it. Don't put both. And you got all this, got this little junk you gotta deal with, you gotta scrape it off and all that. Cleaning is just like any other valve cover, really, just clean it and should be good to go. Alright. After you get it cleaned up, you're gonna take your these. Look at these. They just broke apart when I took them apart. the gaskets for the spark plug holes. And it's pretty fairly simple to figure out. You just, you know, line it up with the holes right there, 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 and just kind of push them in. Like you can tell, like, see how these are real stiff. These aren't, like, they're, that's how used they are. They just come apart really, really easily. Simple, simple, simple. Just make sure they're in there pretty good. You don't want them to leak. Then you're gonna take the big gasket. Always match your gaskets. Because you could, like, some years are different. I don't think the years on these cars are different. Like, from 2001 to 2005, I think they're all the same. But, like, just make sure, you know, you get your gasket. Make sure it's the right gasket. Just kind of eyeball it. Or you can line it up, you know. Make sure it's got the right bends in it, like down there. Where the timing chain goes. Gonna make sure it's got the right bends in it and stuff. And then you just come over here. I don't know why my dog's whining. Just kind of put it on like this. Just match the holes up. Like I said, this is the first valve cover gasket I've done on a BMW, like a 325i like this. So this is all new to me, so what you're seeing is new. I've never done this before. Oh yeah, make sure you get them, like, the metal pieces come off. And when I pulled the metal pieces off, like, this gasket stayed in there. I didn't realize it. It's no big deal. You just grab it where your spark plug holes are, just hang on to it. Grab a flathead, and you're just gonna, like, pry it out just a little bit. It don't take much. You ain't gotta, like, really hulk it out, but it's just like that. Just blow that out. All right, you want to do this real carefully, because if you don't, the gasket will fall. You have to pull the valve cover gasket back out, and you'll have to reposition it and redo it. So just hold it by the spark plug holes, and you know, anywhere you can get a hold of it, really. And just kind of put your fingers right here, and that'll kind of level it out a little bit. You don't want to raise this up. Get it on that, slide it in like so. Just kind of keep it hovering. You don't want that gasket to fall. And then stick her on. Valve cover gasket should be on. Just make sure before you start putting any bolts in or anything like that, just make sure your gasket went on. Because if it didn't, it'll start pouring oil real, real bad. I only tell you this because I've, you know, made my mistakes, done it before. That's the reason I'm making this video, so. All right, gasket's on. I can feel the gaskets in here, they're on. They didn't fall off, of course. Next step is, and I'm gonna speed this process up. Next step will be putting your grommets on your metal nuts to hold they're fairly simple to do. They're not very hard, so it's just, it's all you gotta do. Just pull them off, put the new one on, and it's very, very simple. That's what they look like when they're used. They're all like that. But anyway, fairly simple. I'm gonna speed this process up so it don't take long. Thank you. right, now we're gonna start tightening them up. Now it's just time to like put these back in. So just, like from here it's pretty self-explanatory. You just, you know, you put your wires back down. Like I said, they don't go in like any super special way. You just stick them in those little grooves and they should clip, you know, right in. It goes back on that. And then you're going to need to put that wire back on, just like so. And just take your 8mm socket and you just get it finger tight right for now. Okay, that's not the right one. Forgot. Lord. There we go. Okay, they're over here. Up there to be exact. Yeah, you're just gonna put these back on, like so. Like I said, just use your socket to tighten them up by hand and then use your ratchet. Ain't no sense in swinging that ratchet around like that. It's a waste of time, really. And then you take your ratchet, just snug them up. Like so. And then You got your wires set in. You got them wires up in here. Now you need to pull these wires down. You want to put them around back here. There's like a little slot for them. Just push these under like this. Put them back in the slot. There. And then this one, you ring all the way up here. The wires actually go in first. So just remember that. And voila. Push that around back there. And then you start putting these in. And I'll speed this up too. And then all you have left is those and not just the covers and that cabin filter basically that's it really, and just slide them things back in and then you're done. These of course you pick up. And usually you'd put some dielectric grease on them and plug them back in, but I don't have any dielectric grease right now. So you just plug them back in and you push this down. Pretty simple. I know it's getting dark. GoPros ain't very notorious for being very good in the dark, so sorry. I don't have a hood light, so I was trying to hurry up and get done. But anyway, that's how you do it. I'm basically done. I just got to put all these little pieces back in and it'll be done. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I hope I helped you out learning something, I guess. Anyway, see you later, YouTube.